Let your presence fill this place. Let heaven come. Let your angels be released. Let heaven come. We will worship at your feet. Let heaven come. Face to face we want.
Thank you.
Give you
Thank you. You see.
As merciful as you say, you're as good a father as you say, that we would finally believe that you are worthy of my trust, that you are worthy of my trust. just feel like the Lord just wants us to take a moment just to sing out who he is. That we'd be reminded once again the kind of God that we love, the God that we serve. So I'd like to invite you just to take the next couple of minutes just to sing out. It doesn't need to sound nice. Doesn't need to make sense. But who he has revealed himself to be in your life.
Thank you.
so high above, is slain for us. You alone are worthy, it all revolves, it all revolves around your throne. Who can know your glory? So high above, it's slain for us. You alone. Raining over us. names will fall, but the name of the Lord, it will sound above it all. It will sound above it all. All creation will cry. King of all kings. himself will be with them as our God. Trials and tribulations, and I Trials, Through his His unfailing love. We will not be shaken. We will not be shaken. We will not be shaken.
Stronger, he can do it.
Yes, Lord, we declare that in you we are not shaken, not by sight or circumstances. Yeah, Lord, because you are the one who fights for us. You are strong in battle. You are our triumph. You are our victory. That we get to ride into battle with you. Yeah, Lord, that we get to see how glorious you are in all circumstances. That you invite us into relationship with you so that we can see who you are, God, who you truly are. And we thank you tonight for opening our eyes up to you. All your characteristics, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Tonight, we will be praying for the church in Korea. And as I lead out in prayer, come into agreement with me. And afterwards, please lift up your own intercession. Lord, we recognize you. As we walk out our daily lives, we recognize and that we need to realize how broken we are, God. That the brokenness of man that we are not made fully aware of, you revealed it to us. And it may come as a shock to us, but Lord, you are not surprised. And you still see us as beautiful and worthy of your love. As you continue to show us our true condition and how much we need you, we declare grace to recognize, confess, and confront that we are broken and that we do in fact need you. And I declare grace over the process of confronting our brokenness in a healthy manner, whether it's fraud or bribery or any type of misconduct being exposed in big companies or in politics in Korea, or whether it's emotional pain, hurt, grief in family lives, work lives, or in the Korean church itself. Lord, we just declare that you will continue to expose it so we are noticing what is not right and that you will give us the tools to face it. And Lord, we know that you are allowing us to break off dysfunctional habits, habits like work-based worth, mantras and lies that say that we are valued by only as much as we do. We know this is a lie, God. This is not how you see us. And that is not how we were designed to function. So we break alignment with those things. And Lord, we break alignment with any misinterpretations of how we ought to live our lives. And we ask, oh Lord, that you will not hide yourself from us, but that you will show us yourself and give us the tools to address our deep-rooted issues. Acknowledge the disease and not just put band-aids on our symptoms, God. We declare that you want to see us healed, and Lord, we come into agreement with that. Let us pray.
give us revelation through the example of Jesus of how we ought to live our lives with greater humility, with all the fruits of the Spirit. Not only is it by grace that we are saved, but because of grace of God, we are humbled, and you edify us in our character through humility. And so, Lord, we pray that all the insufficient old ways be removed, that we lay down our old ways that are not working anymore, and that we accept Christ-led change. And even in the government, with the pushing for shorter work hours, we can see changes. And although this is uncomfortable, we declare that God's grace through change, that God give us grace through change, and that he humbles us through change. And that we will see that your way is a better way, and that you are truly a good provider. And Lord, we witness you removing old, unstable things, strong towers being removed, God, we declare that you will show yourself as steady and a firm foundation. And we ask you to interrupt every part of our lives with your good presence, even at the cost of old ways and mindsets. And Jesus, as Jesus humbled himself, we pray that likewise that we humble ourselves, knowing the cost is uncomfortable, but the gain of you is complete. The gain of you completely permeating our lives is worth much more. You will have your bride; she will be made clean, and she will be made ready for your bridegroom. Let us pray. Lord, we recognize that when we were brought close and reconciled to the Father, it was inclusive to being reconciled to his ways and his thought patterns, values, and that we were brought into right functionality in our lives, God. And that in the midst of being reconciled to God, we're being reconciled to each other. So Lord, open up our minds to greater revelation of the depth of reconciliation. bring heaven's viewpoint of reconciliation into the Korean church. There is communion that takes place not only vertically between us and God, but horizontally with God's people. And so, Lord, I just declare grace over the communion, grace over reconciliation when we fight and hurt one another. Lord, we pray grace over the recognition of repentance and of wrongdoings as you reconcile members of the Korean church and even reconciliation of the two Koreas. We can see your footprints of reconciliation and how the South Korean government is trying to be reconciled to North Korea. And then in those efforts, we can see though that you are reconciling families. You know, through all of the policies and inter-Korean talks, we can see a push toward the spirit of reconciliation. And so, Lord, we declare that the church would not be behind, but be leading in reconciliation. And lead not by man, but by the Father. And we speak out into the atmosphere, hope, rise up. Hope for better relations and communications in the Korean church and the Korean government. Let us pray. Honor you, Lord, because you are gracious. We recognize that grace isn't just about not feeling the weight of the world or not being bothered by anything, but grace is the fact that you, Lord, will interrupt our plans to connect us to your plans, and that you would take us from our mediocre lives and bring us into a life with you, which is more glorious beyond measure. And we don't need to be living continuously on high to be met by the Most High. So, God, would you meet us even in the low and high places, in the mundane places and in exciting places. You are a God of still quiet. You are a God who is a roaring lion. And so we declare that the experience of how you continually meet us would spark greater praise in the church here in Korea. We fix our eyes on you and we say, holy is the Lord God Almighty, and worthy are you to be praised. We speak that the church in Korea will honor you with shouts of praise in all circumstances. Jesus, We are thankful for your friendship, your leadership, for your presence, for your sacrifice, for your love that is not based on any condition, but is based on your character. You are a loving God, and you love us. You just love us. And so we receive it with thanksgiving. And we choose to be impressed with our God and not our circumstances. We choose satisfaction in the Lord. And we ask that you continuously overwhelm the church with satisfaction in you. Let us pray. Draws near to the brokenhearted, and you do not despise a contrite heart. Lord, you say, blessed are the poor in spirit, for they will inherit the kingdom of heaven. Yeah. You have brought us into wealth we have not earned, and you have made us co-heirs, and you deem us worthy of love, and we just thank you, God. We are in thanksgiving. Yeah, that you brought us in even when we were enemies, when we fought against you, when we still fight against you. You still bring us in. You still offer us, yeah, the rights to the kingdom, God. And so we just declare, God, we declare that there be grace over us to be humble, to receive you, God. Yeah, to see you as you show and reveal yourself, that we see you rightly, God. Yeah, Lord. And as you renew and restore us, God, we just are in so much thanksgiving. Because of you, we are brought near. Yeah, Lord. Thank you. Amen.
Thank you for joining us tonight.